The Calculus Controversy, The Development of Modern Calculus, digital story by Emily McDonald. In this digital story, we will identify who invented calculus and explore the infamous controversy of its discovery. Today, calculus is one of the most important branches of mathematics, with applications in science, engineering, and economics. But who invented calculus? Well, that answer is a little complicated. One of the most infamous controversies in the history of mathematics is the one between Isaac Newton and Gottfried Leibniz over the invention of modern calculus. Of course, the history of calculus does not begin with Newton and Leibniz. Their contributions were a result of the culmination of centuries of work by many other mathematicians. So what is calculus? Well, calculus is the mathematics that describes how something changes instantaneously. So it is the study of the relationships of limits, integrals, and derivatives. Although Newton and Leibniz frequently quarreled over who was the true discoverer of calculus, the mathematics community as a whole agrees that both individuals left a profound impact on calculus. While their contributions were developed independently, with each mathematician approaching the subject from a varying viewpoint, Newton's and Leibniz's ideas provided a strong foundation of calculus. Isaac Newton, an English physicist and mathematician, began his work on calculus around 1666. However, he published relatively none of his work until the time between 1693 and 1704. Newton started his work by attempting to find the slope of a tangent line to the curve at any point. Newton used mostly geometric proofs, which led him to discover differentiation and integration, and this resulted in him publishing the first fundamental theorem of calculus. Gottfried Leibniz, a German mathematician, published his work in 1684 and approached the subject in a more analytical and less graphical manner than Newton. Much of Leibniz's notation is still used today. The calculus controversy emerged largely due to the timing of these men's publications. While Newton had made his discoveries between 1664 and 1666, Newton's findings were not published until 1693. Leibniz, on the other hand, made his discoveries after Newton in a time frame between 1672 and 1676, but published them in 1684 and 1686 before Newton. The differences between the discovery dates and publication dates led the mathematical community to question whether Leibniz had truly discovered the methods independently of Newton, or had Leibniz merely stolen Newton's idea and added his own unique notation. National pride was a substantial force in the calculus dispute. Those involved realized that credit for the discovery of a whole new branch of math was at stake, and each side wanted their country to get the credit. In 1711, this controversy was taken to court. A commission was appointed by the Royal Society to look into the charges. Since Newton was the president of the Royal Society, it is not at all surprising that Leibniz was found guilty of plagiarism. Eventually, the mathematical community came to realize that Newton and Leibniz had made their discoveries independently, but this was not until years after Leibniz's death. As a piece of history, this controversy serves as a lesson to the modern world that it is better for great minds to work together instead of trying to undermine each other. The public may never know who the real first inventor of calculus was, but both Newton and Leibniz were truly innovators in the field of mathematics.